People need magic in their lives because in the world that we're living in now, people are so used to just understanding everything with technology and science. David from accounts understands the world that he lives in. It all makes sense to him and everything becomes mundane. But when you show someone something that they can't explain, it makes us feel like children again. My name is James Harrington and I'm a kind of magician, illusionist, mind reader, professional liar, I suppose is the real term. I started learning when I was 6. It was like a childhood obsession. I used to have a magician at my birthday parties. And then on my 7th birthday, I wanted to do my own show. So my parents bought me a little magic box. And I laid all the tricks around on the table, like trying to make it look professional, tied a t-shirt around my neck like a cape. And all my friends arrived, I did the show. No one watched, I cried for hours. It was a traumatic beginning, but that was it. My first job when I was 17 was in TGI Fridays for £5 an hour every Saturday evening. And I had no idea how difficult it was gonna be to walk up to a group and start trying to do magic. Because there's no reason for me to do that. When do you ever do that? 17 years old, a socially inept teenager with a pack of cards. I'm gonna have to walk up to this table and do a load of tricks for them. I would walk up and then I would get so nervous and I'd just carry on walking past. And it would take about 4 or 5 walk-up attempts before I actually developed the courage to actually walk up to them and say, hey, can I show you some tricks? My first show, I must have been 18 years old. And I'd gone to meet an agent and did a little demo for him. He liked it, he decided to book me for a wedding. And it was about 2 hours away from where I lived. So I paid my dad £50 to take me there and wait. And I went in, I did 2 hours at the wedding. And it went well. And I really enjoyed the buzz that I got from it. But then I got handed an envelope at the end with the money in it. I'm 18 years old and I've never had a job. And it was £350 cash. And I remember getting out and sitting in the car with my dad looking at this money and feeling like I'd robbed them or something like that. Like, how can I have just been given this much money to do something that I love doing? This is called card control. In the time it took me to learn this, I could have become a doctor.
Really?
Mm. I made my mother a lot happier, bless her. If I cast a shadow, it changes into the Queen of Diamonds. One more queen to go. Just say stop anytime you like.
Yeah. Stop.
Take it or carry on, it's up to you. Queen number 4, thank you so much. Thank you. So I would see a trick that fooled me, and then I would think, if I can just do that one trick, I'll be made, that'll be it. And what happens as a magician is you see that, you learn the trick, but then it's never enough, it's never quite enough because you're never really a superhero. It's not an easy career to begin. So for years, I was struggling, I didn't have a penny to my name. There was a time I moved out early from my house because we didn't come from money. As soon as I started working at TGI's after I'd left school, I had to pay rent to my family, which I couldn't afford. So then we got into some fights and it kind of went downhill a bit. And then I ended up moving into an apartment that someone was subletting, who then eventually kicked me out because I couldn't pay rent. Then I slept in my car for a little while. Then eventually I found a room and then I kept on trying these kind of short temp jobs, but kept on walking out because all I wanted to do was be a magician. It was a terribly irresponsible way to live. Can you put your signature just along on the face of it? But sign it the way that you sign a check. Oh. This is a trouble now. I'm going to make every single card in the pack. Wait, I'll keep this one. But when I snap, the rest of them disappear. You believe me? Can you feel them now?
Yeah.
But they've gone already. Yeah. No. Lift your hand up, every single card, completely gone. They of course go over here into the box right where they started. Thank you so much, thank you. The hardest crowd are the reserved crowds, where they feel a bit uncomfortable. Maybe if it's a group of, like a company has all their clients at a dinner and they don't know each other. And maybe it's a really fancy hotel. They feel a little bit uptight. There are essentially only five tricks, and everything else is a variation on that. There's vanish, appear, levitate, penetrate, and restore. Any kind of close-up trick or stage trick that you see is basically a variation on those five. There's one more, which is the sixth one, which is where we're going to now, and that's the magic of the mind, which kind of falls into a different category from the rest. But that's why it's so fascinating for us and why we want to delve so deeply into it. If I want someone to look at something and miss what I'm doing in the other hand, it doesn't work the way that you think it works. Because if I try to distract you over here, you know that you're trying to be distracted. So what you actually do is look here, but this is where I do the secret move. So it's the complete reverse of the way most people think misdirection would work. As soon as you walk up to a table, for example, if I'm doing close-up magic, the first thing they're gonna think is, how long is he gonna be here? Is he gonna be good? They give you a little bit of trust when they say, okay, show me some magic. Because if it's awful, it's gonna be very awkward for them. And it's not a pleasant experience. So the showmanship is all about putting people at ease, making people relaxed, letting people have a good time, because they don't want a bad magician. And any kind of heckler, any person that's trying to catch you out on a trick, all they're doing is saying, I want to prove that you're good enough. My favorite thing to do at the moment is what I do with Marina.
I will try and tell you the security code now.
Well.
I'm sensing 0, 2, 5.
0, 2, 5. Is it 0, 2, 5? It is exactly 0, 2, 5.
Oh, okay, great. Thank you, guys. My name is Marina, and I'm a part of Mind to Mind duo, together with James.
We do this this mind reading act, and it's completely different to all the things that I grew up learning, all the techniques, all the card tricks, and all this kind of stuff. And it becomes something that's so much more personal to people. And it's also amazing to be able to work with the other half.
I think it's most girls' dreams to always be next to the one you love. I don't know how he feels about it, but I feel great when we have to go to work together and we come back together, so we're basically together the whole time.
You don't know how I feel about it? I'll tell you.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Will you tell us what the cards are?
Yes, the first card is definitely a red card. I think it's 7 of hearts.
Perfect.
And the last one is definitely a queen, but I think it's black. It's queen of spades.
Thank you, guys. Well done. With the mind stuff, the hardest part is the energy that we need within performance to keep it going. It's very straining. People think it's an easy job. And I'm glad that I work with Marina, because usually a magician has a trouble with their other half because they think, oh, they go out and work 2 hours, how are they possibly tired? But she understands that it's exhausting. I've always thought it was either going to be, I was going to be a magician or a tramp. because I couldn't ever have done anything else. What I would tell the 6-year-old me is I'm so sorry. And no matter how hard it gets, it's gonna be okay in the end.